Welcome students. Here we will discuss about reliability, bathtub curve and quality. Reliability. First, take two examples. Among the first, if you purchase a car and if that doesn't need to go to the garage for repairs often, during its lifetime would be said to have been reliable. In another case, if a product that will not work or it breaks down as soon as you purchase it, that product is to have the low or poor quality. Reliability is associated with the unexpected failures of products or services, and understanding why these failures occur is the key to improving the reliability. Reliability is defined as the probability that the unit or item will perform the required function, that is the intended function, without failure under the stated conditions for a stated period of time. As it is denoted by the probability, so reliability, that is R of t, is equal to probability with respect to time capital T, which is greater than the starting time. If that time is equal to zero, then that means when we will start using the product, the reliability will be equal to one, that is the 100% probability. And when the time is infinity, then the reliability will be equal to zero. We can say simply, reliability is the quality over time. Reliability must be designed into a product or a service. Most important aspect of reliability is to identify the cause of failure and eliminate in design if possible. Otherwise, identify the ways of accommodating the reliability. Implications or the different consequences of poor reliability. The very first is the safety. So, if the product is not reliable, then some hazards or accidents may happen very quickly. Second, the competitiveness. If the product is not a reliable one, then the competitor may develop their business in comparison with your product. Profit margins. For a reliable product, always the profit margins will be high. Cost of repair and maintenance. If the product is reliable, then as we have seen the very first example of a car, so the cost of repair and maintenance will be surely low. The reputation of the industry or the manufacturer will surely increase because of the highly reliable product. As well as the last point will be goodwill. The goodwill of the manufacturer may go down with the poor reliability product. Now we will go for what are the different causes of failures that will cause unreliability. The first is poor design. So when we are starting the designing of any product or atom or an instrument or machine, so if the design is not very good design, then the reliability will be less. Wrong manufacturing practices or techniques. Many a times, to decrease the cost of manufacturing, the industry may adopt some wrong manufacturing practices or some techniques which may be like the shortcuts or the poor manufacturing techniques. Wrong specifications. So at the time of design, if the specifications are not that much correct, because specifications are one of the main input for the designing of an instrument or machine. Lack of total knowledge and experience. A very new industry, not having so much experience and the knowledge of the product in the design phase, that may cause less reliable products. Complexity of equipment may unnecessarily increase the unreliability. Poor maintenance policies. Because some industries think that the maintenance cost is higher, then they will not go very oftenly for the maintenance, and that's why the reliability will surely decrease. Organizational rigidity and complexity. So if that will be the case, then very easily the maintenance cannot be undergone. And the last will be the human errors. So these are the various causes of failures that leads to unreliability. Now, the different techniques to enhance reliability. First one, parts improvement method. The various parts or components, if you will use in the design of higher standard, then that will surely enhance the reliability. Effective and creative design. System simplification. If the system seems to be a very complicated one, you can break that system into different simple subsystems, and then you can incorporate all these into a simple system. Use of overrated components, mainly in terms of the specifications or the ratings. If we will use from safety point of view the overrated components, then that will also enhance the reliability. Structural redundancy. So if there is a failure of some component or part, then a parallel part may take over the operation. That is called as a structural redundancy. Maintenance and repair. So if you will have the scheduled maintenance, then very easily the reliability will get improved. The bathtub curve. The bathtub curve is a representation of the reliability performance of components or non-repaired items. It observes the reliability performance of a large sample of homogeneous items entering the field at some start time. Usually, that is considered to be zero. If we observe the items over their lifetime without replacement, then we can observe three distinct shapes or periods in the bathtub curve. As the shape of the curve is very similar to the bathtub, that's why the name is bathtub curve. The figure shows a hypothetical example of the bathtub curve where it is being divided in three different modes, or you may say regions. The curve is plotted in terms of failure rate against time. Individually, we will go for each and every mode, and then we will go for a combined curve. The line, that is the dotted line shown in red color, it is the failure rate which is high at the start time, and then it decreases as the time increases. The second will be the constant, or called as the random failures. So failure rate is considered to be constant with respect to time. and the third shown by the orange dotted line, it is the wear out failures. Means when we are going to use the machine, the item or the product for a longer time, some of the parts may undergo wear out, and that's why the wear out failures will increase with respect to time. So the blue colored curve is the observed failure rate curve, or called as the bathtub curve. Now the three different modes are: first, the decreasing failure rate; second, the constant failure rate; and the third, increasing failure rate. In next slides we will go one by one. First, early failures. It is also called as initial or infant mortality failure. It may be due to manufacturing defects, weak parts used in the manufacturing, bad assembly, poor fits, and poor insulation in case of the wires that we are going to use. This early failure rate is higher because when there are so many causes that may lead to early failure in case of that particular product. It is also called as debugging or burn-in period. The second is catastrophic failures or the random failures. It is very difficult to determine the causes of random failures because when we are using continuously the product, then the failure will not occur often. The time of normal operation, it is the useful life of the unit or the product. The third region or mode is the wear out failures. The unit gets worn out and deteriorate. The performance determining parameters changes and goes beyond acceptable limits, and the unit will fail. Now, in brief, we will go for the difference between the reliability and quality. Reliability, it is the probability that unit or the item will perform the required function or intended function without failure under stated conditions for a stated period of time. Whereas quality is nothing but the degree of conformance to the acceptable or applicable specifications and workmanship standards. Reliability is associated with design, and quality is associated with manufacturing. Reliability depends on time and the environment, whereas quality is not concerned with time and environment. You can define the reliability by numerical value, but for quality, it can't be defined by any numerical value. One can design a reliable system using less reliable elements, but it is impossible to construct a good quality system with poor quality elements. So in these different points, we can easily differentiate between reliability and quality. Thank you.